Night, January 2nd, 1924.
What a curious, clutching, gripping, tense feeling it gave one to awaken to the sound of the town criers. A little help needed here. Horseman house on fire. A little help needed here. After as much salvaging as could possibly be done, one watched the third floor give way. The beams curved before they fell, the flames raced to the first floor, the swish of drying and falling plaster.
4 months later, students, staff, and alumni received a brief postcard from then-President Arthur Morgan.
Dear Antiochian, in a few days we shall send you a letter about the Horace Mann Memorial Library, to be built on the foundations of the President's house, which was burned last January. This is one of the most fitting memorials we could erect to Horace Mann. Cordially, Arthur E. Morgan, President, May 12, 1924.
Though the library grew, the space didn't, and things quickly started to get cramped.
The Horace Mann Library could never hold all the library books. From 1930 on, science books were housed in a single large room in the science building.
In January of 1953, Dr. Douglas McGregor, president of Antioch College, announced the gift of a new library building to Antioch College by a longtime friend of the college and former trustee, Dr. Charles F. Kettering. In November of 1953, the structural steel of the Olive Kettering Library was being bolted into place. In March of 1954, the building of the walls and brickwork had begun. The building would house the college's 100,000-volume collection with room for expansion. A bargain in boxes was discovered in March of 1955 by Paul Bixler as he faced the prospect of moving 100,000 books from the present library into the new library that summer. When asked about his vacation plans, fellow librarian Bruce Thomas remarked,
"I expect to devote my summer to travel and books. Traveling between North and South College Streets, moving about 100,000 books."
As the ceremony drew to a close, Mr. Kettering looked on with satisfaction as the keys to the building circulated from the architects to Trustee David Reich and then to President Samuel B. Gould. Olive Kettering Library is still going strong, housing more than 325,000 volumes, 900 periodicals, and 4,000 phonograph records. ¶¶